Grateful. Now, if you've been following the Afrobarometer on corruption, it's been said over and over and over again that the Ghana Police Service is the most corrupt institution in the country. The service has actually topped these service for several years. Now, the Asante Regional Police Commander is insisting that, well, you don't blame the police service. The culture of Ghana enhances corruption. Let's watch excerpts of the interview he granted Hot Issues' Kwesi Pratt.
The visibility is for people to be see the police, both the criminals and the innocent people, to see the police and know that if something happens here now, I can go and talk to the police. Mm-hmm. Also, it makes the people feel confident, because eventually when you are going on the highway, you see police here. You feel confident, and the criminals also, it deters them. But at this level, I think it's a time that we have to go further, and that's why we have started building police posts along the road.
The container police post.
Yes,
and
that is.
Yeah.
In fact, I met the KMA assemblyman, and I said, even if you can put little kiosks and paint it police, I'll come and put one policeman in with walkie-talkie. So what kind of methodology, what was your point of reference? And that's my problem. And between me and you, if now we go and interview people at the harbor alone, they will have who is more corrupt there.
Exactly.
When we go and interview teachers or people who want to be admitted, JSS, you know who is more corrupt. But you know, police, among all the works, police, we are the interface between the law and the public. Is that right?
Mm-hmm.
And they see us more. Policemen are always on the road. And even the police corruption they're talking about is only on the roads, the MTU, which we have accepted that is bad. Mm-hmm. But who gives them the money? Quite apart from that, traditionally, culturally, our system endorses corruption. Look at all our proverbs. Are these not corrupt proverbs? Therefore, we have to look at our own culture.
Mm-hmm.
So saying that police is corrupt is so easy, because these are the people you see outside. Who else do you see outside? Mm-hmm. And let's also look at the quantum. One man's corruption can dupe the country for about $10 million.
Can kill thousands of people.
Yes. And police corruption, one city. So is it the quantum or the numbers? And is it because we are always on the... So,
right, really, following what DCOP Kofi Boakye was saying. But let's try and make some sense of what he's trying to say, suggesting that Ghana's traditional culture and values shows corruption. And in fact, he's suggesting that that is what is enhancing, encouraging corruption. Let's speak to a lecturer from the Sociology Department of the University of Ghana, Samson Appiah. He's just joined me on phone. Samson, grateful to have you tonight.
Good evening, yeah.
Mm. Now, DCOP Kofi Boakye's statement is clear. He is suggesting that Ghana's cultural values encourages, motivates corruption. Tell me, is this something you agree?
Thank you very much for the opportunity. I think to some extent I will agree with some of the things he said, and to some extent I will disagree with what he said. First of all, let's understand that culture is dynamic and not static.
Right.
And then culture is dynamic but not static. And we all know that culture is just a way of people, their knowledge, their beliefs, their customs, their values, etc. Yes, so we can say that traditional societies have ways of life which, in a way, can provide some mechanisms by which people and involved in some activities. Yes, we can say that traditional societies, some of our value systems in a way promote, corruption and bribery. We all know that the traditional political system where chiefs were given power to have control of resources, so that they were respected and feared because of the fact that they possessed the power to rule the people. So the real fact is when you go to our chiefs for arbitration, whatever, they're supposed to send drinks and gifts to them. So in a way, it promoted the idea that once you go to the chief or the elder with some kind of a gift or those things, the means of saying that they're supposed to give you judgment or give you things in favor. But in those times, the point also must be made clear that the religious system of that even the chiefs themselves were a bit cautious of giving judgment. Because if you don't give judgment according to what ancestors say, it may come against you, the chief, yourself. You get the point? Yeah, so in such a way, we can say that even though the cultural values are that people saw that as a means by which the chiefs, the gift of the chiefs, in a means of getting judgment, could breed corruption or bribery.
Please, hold your thought here. Let me cut in. Is it not simplifying issues? For instance, with what you're talking about, the traditional people know that they needed to feed their chief. I mean, they do not actually wait for when they have a case before the chief, before they go give the chief some plantain or some cassava or some gift. It is incumbent on the people who have elected the chief to ensure that the chief lives well. So to say that is that can corrupt the chief, is it not just simplifying the issue?
We will not see it was a means of simplifying the issue because at the point was that, but that is what I was coming to the next point, that the traditional reciprocity was also something that contributed to that. In a sense that we do things for people in a sense that once you give that gift to the person, the meaning is that the person must also do something to reciprocate what you have done. So when you go to the chief, that the idea is that you are expecting something from the person, not immediately, or maybe not in the same form. So the traditional reciprocity as a value of the African and the Ghanaian was a means of promoting the idea that once you give something to the person, you must provide, you must also do something for you in return. So in a way, the point I'm also making is that we should also not lose sight of the fact that even though that was the case, the religious system was such that even the chief was careful in giving judgment accurately.
Right.
Because ancestors are believed to be controlling that. You get the point? So the idea, if the chief does not give judgment according to what ancestors are supposed to see, it may come back to him or may backfire on his face. So in a way, that may have a means of influencing the judgment by going the right way. But the other point I also make about what he said also was that if you apart from the traditional political system, our traditional value system of reciprocity, where not even only the chiefs, even anything we do in our case system, we believe in reciprocity. So our case system is like that. When we do things for people, for example, this is what we talk about the fact that even though the villager of somebody, let's come the money society, somebody from a village, someone from a bureaucracy or the public service does something for a villager. And the villager in genuine way to reciprocate may try to do that, but for the politician or the bureaucrat, he knows the right thing, but they still want to take advantage of the ignorance of the village or traditional person by just taking what the person does. So the point is that the person may be doing that out of a genuine way of reciprocity with our traditional value, that we must always try to do things for people when they do something for us. So in a way, that also promotes the idea of corruption. But also, we also not forgot about the fact that our kinship, our extended family system, in a way also put pressure on individuals. We all know it that, for example, most of our people are supposed to work in public institutions. Their salaries are not so much. But when people expect them to provide everything for them, your extended families, your uncles, your nephews, at times they don't know how much you get. But the point is that you're expected to provide. So when there's so much pressure on you from the extended family system, people do all sort of things to get all that extra money or other resources from where they are not supposed to get it from. So, you know, it also put pressure on us to get more of those things, and it brings corruption and bribing of that.
Let's also check one of the things Mr. Kofi Boakye said. And you, for instance, from the beginning said that culture is dynamic. Now, we know that our cultural values have evolved more than 1,000 years, which means that we have changed. Now, Mr. Kofi Boakye is insisting that even though we have changed, the nature of our culture is what is encouraging corruption now. Culture that is dynamic, culture that has evolved over a period, and it is still motivating corruption. That's quite confusing.
Now, when we say culture is dynamic and not static, sociologists also say that the change is not, I mean, a rapid. It's a gradual change.
But in our traditional societies now, the chiefs do not sit on cases.
Yes. Yes, the chiefs do not sit on cases. But the fact is that even though the chiefs don't sit on cases, we have that become part of our attitude and our behavior. So that today you may not, if you are going to see maybe a judge or even a lawyer or something, we all know some of these things in our judiciary. As a lawyer, even send or lead, I mean, litigants to judges' houses to provide some of these gifts for them. So the point is that it's something we have taken for the traditional society, which has become part and parcel of our life. So that it has been extended to our modern institutions. These are the point there. So even though chiefs don't sit on cases today, we have extended this attitude and behavior to other modern institutions of society.
Can we?
I get the point.
I get it, but can we ever get rid of this cultural sin that is encouraging corruption? Can we change?
Yes,
is it possible?
I think that is what I said earlier on, that even though we are looking at culture, the culture also has a positive aspect. For instance, I have always made the point that in traditional societies, people question people's sources of wealth, which is part of our traditional beliefs. But what we see today, in our modern societies, a lot of young people live in the urban areas. They do all sorts of things, some are into 419, some are into whatever they do. But when you get back to the traditional societies of the urban area, people don't question their sources of wealth. I believe that as a society, we can go back to some aspects of the cultural values, which also we are against this vibrant corruption. That's how we ensure that we question people's source of wealth. Even in the churches today, people don't ask where do they get their money from. They don't know how much the person gives to us in church. They make the person an elder or a deacon or a chairman or whatever. So I believe that even though some aspect of our culture promotes that aspect, the other positive aspect that we are against, I mean, corruption and bribery, and I believe that we can all live as African Ghanaians by saying that let's look at the positive aspect. How do we in the past try to question the people of the world and ask where they're getting their money from, and also provide a social support, which is very important. In the past, people provided support for their neighbors. But today, we are becoming individualistic, which also is a means that we could become individualistic and also make sure that they only show their wealth by doing the bad things to get their money. So I believe that, yes, we can also look at the same culture and ask ourselves, how can we make sure that these aspects are positive and help us to, I mean, fight against the bribery and the corruption of society?
Grateful to have you to speak to tonight. Samson Appiah is a lecturer at the Sociology Department of the University of Ghana. They're talking to me about some statement that the Ashanti Regional Police Commander made on hot issues. But he cited several proverbs that he suggested promote corruption. Let me play you back those proverbs.
Traditionally, culturally, our system endorses corruption. Look at all our proverbs. Are these not corrupt proverbs?
Well, Obipe Adiako Kotokwa. Yeah, Mbona, bro. That's DCOP Kofi Boakye, one of the proverbs he says promotes corruption. That's how we're wrapping up on the big one for now.